this is the Balkan guy, and today I will be reacting to the UK song for Eurovision 2022. We have Sam Ryder with the song Spaceman. Now that title of the song is so promising to me. I feel like usually with these type of songs, I feel like it's gonna be, I don't know, maybe Elton John-ish? I don't know, I love Elton John, so I hope something like Elton John. A lot of people have been hyping this song up to me and telling me it's really good and does have really strong potential in Eurovision. The UK brought it back strong, so I'm really excited to go ahead and listen to it. I will give my fully honest opinion on this song, and if you appreciate honest opinions and reactions where I freak out about songs that I really, really like, make sure to subscribe to this channel, make sure to follow me on my Instagram, because I always, always appreciate that. Now let's go ahead and get into the song and see what I think about it. I'm nervous. I really want the UK to do well.
Welcome back to Sunday.
I want this to be good so bad.
Mr. Sam Ryder.
It's fantastic to be here.
Okay,
well,
you know, it's interesting.
It's an honor for you to be here. Tell me,
what's interesting is that one interior is on this here, the other one person is here. Oh, okay, what's happening?
If I was an astronaut, I'd be floating in midair. And a broken heart.
He has an really interesting voice, very high. Down
I would be the center of my lonely universe, but I'm only human, and I'm crashing down to earth. If I was an astronaut, I'd have a bird's eye.
I love the melodies in the background.
I'd circle around the world and keep on coming back to you.
In a way, this doesn't sound like any other UK entry, but it sounds like a typical UK entry. I don't know if that makes sense. Hey. This is not what I expected at all. Nothing but space. And I wanna go home.
If I was an astronaut, I'd speak to satellites.
I feel like I like this song.
Search for other
life. And this might be a pattern with the UK. I like it for, like, to listen to it on Spotify. But I'm not sure how it's gonna do in Europe. And I'm not sure if this song is for Eurovision. Can he sing this live? Is there like a live performance anywhere? Because this sounds extremely hard to sing. His hair is very luscious. And the music video is very interesting. I'm just not sure how I feel about the song. Bridge. Come on, bring it. I'm gonna need him to finish real strong. He goes real high. Like real high. I should be careful with glass around here because it's about to break with his voice. Shit. He has a good vocal. He's a really good vocal. It's very catchy. It makes me want to sing it, but I literally cannot physically sing this. Like, it's... no. It's way too high.
I've searched around the universe, been down some black holes, not filled with space, man. And I wanna go home.
Yeah, the interior is like, what just happened? You're about to say you gotta be fucking kidding me. Okay, that's hilarious. I do love the music video. It's very creative. The song, I feel like I have very, very mixed feelings. They're, in a way, it's good. It's really catchy. It's the type of song I would have on my Spotify playlist. But I will be 100% honest with you guys. I don't see this doing well in Eurovision. I don't see people picking up their phones to vote for this. I don't know, like, it's good, but it's not wow good. It's not like, you know how Eurovision works. Eurovision is a final, well, this year is going to be 25 songs, and people are only going to vote for one. People only care for the one they like the most. I see this being in people's top 10s, but I don't see this being number one for a lot of people. So I don't think this is going to do well in Eurovision. I'm really, really sorry. And it hurts me to say it as well, because I want the UK to do well. I do want, because I've loved the UK entries basically almost every single year, and I think UK gets so robbed. Like, 2014, UK was my winner. 2016 with Julie Jones, Lucy Jones. That was her name. She was also one of my winner. 2020, James Newman with a song, Last Breath. Loved it. It was in my top five. Last year, Embers, I thought it was an amazing song. UK keeps getting robbed. And I have a feeling this is also gonna be one of those years that UK is gonna get robbed. I'm sorry. I know y'all hate me for saying that. And please don't go ahead in the comments and be like, oh, you're stupid. No. That's just my prediction, and that's just what I think, but I do like the song. I don't think it's a bad song in any way, and I love his voice. I hope he can sing that live, because my man was going high up in the sky with those notes. Like, I could never even imagine. I can see myself, like, after recording this video, I can see myself playing the song and trying to sing it, and I'm just gonna sound like a dying chicken. Because there's no way in heaven I can ever do anything like that. But yeah, that is my reaction to the UK song for Eurovision 2022. I hope you guys enjoyed my reaction. And if you did, make sure to subscribe to my channel. Like and comment down below what you think about this song. Do you like it? Do you think it's going to do well? And last but not least, make sure to follow me on my Instagram, because I always, always appreciate that. And I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye. I did it the wrong way. I usually do it this way. Let me repeat it real quick. I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.